President Trump's attorneys, Rudy Giuliani and Jay Sekulow, are sounding off on bias within the special counsel's team, they say, after that release of the report on Friday night. One America's Neil W. McCabe sat down with President Trump's legal team to discuss.
When Barr came out with his four-page letter, can you sort of compare that with what you were expecting going in and what you got?
Well, I think it's fair to say on Friday what we expected was that we were about to get with what the Attorney General called the principal conclusions by the weekend. So we were pleased that it had come to conclusion. That was obviously very big news for us. And then we were prepared for, we all met in my office on Sunday, Rudy and I and the Raskins, and we were in and we waited for the report.
And was it what you expected? Had you been picking up hints?
You don't pick up hints. We knew I'll let Rudy address this. We knew the law. We knew the facts. So we knew there was no obstruction and we knew there was no collusion. The question is, what are they going to say and how are they going to say it?
Right. I think we were all comfortable that there was absolutely no evidence of collusion and that there was no obstruction. I mean, we knew that. The question was, how strongly were they going to say that? Given the fact that I know now that it's over, I think this is a correct result. But it was a group of people that were highly biased against him. It's not as if this was a neutral group of people. 8 or 10 of them were very, very rabid Democrats, big supporters of Hillary Clinton. One worked for the Clinton Foundation, Janie Rhee, which is absurd to have somebody like that involved in something like this. So we also had to be aware of the fact that they might well try to spin things against him. So when I said this is better than I expected, you know, snide comments and a few innuendos. And I mean, the evidence just doesn't allow it.
Did you get the sense that Mueller was having trouble reining in part of his teams, particularly Andrew Weissman?
Throughout. He didn't rein in Andrew Weissman. Andrew Weissman did things that he should be held to account for. Now, he shouldn't have selected him in the first place. All you have to do is look at his record. You say to yourself, the guy puts people in harsh conditions of confinement in order to break them. He makes up crimes. He's been found to have done that. Cases thrown out where the courts say, hey, no crime here. And he was a very, very partisan person with regard to Hillary Clinton. Plus, he had early information about this. He was involved, nobody knew this until the end, but he was involved way back in talking about this possible allegation, which turns out to be a creation of someone.
A complete fraud. I mean, if you look at what did this start as? This was supposed to be a counterintelligence investigation. Crossfire Hurricane was its code name. It was a complete fabricated start. So the irregularities from the beginning of this inquiry till its conclusion were breathtaking. You could go through the Peter Strzok, Lisa Page, Bruce and Nellie Orr. I mean, these are not normal. And then when Strzok and Page get fired by Bob Mueller, their phones get wiped. I mean, you know, now we kind of forget all of that stuff. But this was not a normal investigation by any stretch of the imagination.
Some might call that obstruction of justice, perhaps.
Yeah, might.
Far
more. Maybe somebody will.
You know, it occurs to me that they did conduct a counterintelligence investigation, probably as a way of getting around no probable cause, no crime that they're really investigating. However, the counterintelligence investigation had the same result as this one. Remember Peter Strzok, who said there's no there? Page said that, Strzok said that. So then they launch a criminal investigation after a counterintelligence investigation yielded no evidence of any involvement of Donald Trump or his campaign with the Russians. Somebody's got to find out, how did that happen? How did that distortion of our justice system occur?
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.